Why use R? First up, R is really fast. Spreadsheets that take over an hour to calculate in Excel, usually due to things like VLOOKUPs and SUMIFS, can calculate in less than a second in R. Related to speed is capacity. Where Excel can really only handle thousands of records, R can handle millions. Now, although technically Excel can handle a million rows of data, if you've ever tried to add a calculated column to your dataset, you'll very quickly find out that that's not the case. Now, to understand this, let's say that you're adding a VLOOKUP to your data, and it had a million rows. You enter your formula once, but then you copy it down a million times. That means the calculation has to calculate 1 million times. If you then have to look up five columns, that becomes 5 million calculations. If you get fancy and try to automatically look up the column name using a match formula, you've just doubled your calculations to 10 million calculations that need to run every time you accidentally touch something in your spreadsheet, which is why people often do copy-paste special values. In R, all of that is a single calculation. Reduce risk, make your work reproducible, and automate it all at the same time. Now in Excel, if you have a bunch of process notes, which include things like copy and paste over this data set here, add a new column, insert this formula, fill the formula down, copy paste special values, and then update your formula ranges to make the whole thing work again, you're introducing manual processes and risk to your work. Now, if you know a little bit of VBA, you might think, well, I'm actually automating those processes instead. The thing is, typically, the VBA code to automate these processes is around 10 times longer than it is in R. Now, to understand this, R was designed to work directly with your data. So if you need to add a calculated column, that's around one line of code, which basically specifies your formula and business logic. In VBA, you're effectively coding all the steps that you would have manually done in Excel. This is why VBA takes so much longer to write and also takes much longer to run. Risk is reduced in R because you can always get back to your original dataset. Every step of the process that you've got in place is part of your script, which means if you need to tweak or update and make a change to that logic, you can very quickly make that change and run the entire script from your original data within seconds. Visualizations and dashboards. The visualizations in R are much closer to a product like Tableau than they are Excel. The other benefit of producing your visualizations in R instead of something like Tableau is the licensing costs. If you do all your fancy work in Tableau, if you want to send that work to somebody, you'll usually need to export it as a static format, like a PDF or an image file. If you want to send your work with all of its interactivity, your user is going to either need to have Tableau installed on their computer, or you need to purchase a license for them on a Tableau server, which can start to get really expensive and make it really difficult to distribute your work. With R, if you want to send out an interactive visualization, you can send it as an HTML file, which can be opened in somebody's web browser. This makes it much easier to distribute your work as it was intended to be viewed. When it comes to dashboards, the typical way to make a dashboard dynamic in Excel is by using slicers. Now, if you want to implement other things, you typically need to start using some VBA, which then starts to get a little bit complicated and reduces compatibility. Now, the problem with slicers is that they really only cover filters, which basically means it's not possible to customize groupings and summaries and calculations on the fly. What that typically means is that if you look at most Excel dashboards, they're usually produced at a very high level so that they're generic enough even when the filters are applied. This is all fine when you're presenting your dashboard to the group management team, but when you want to start to roll out your dashboard to the rest of the businesses, it usually doesn't have enough granularity in it to be actually useful to anyone. In R, you can just as easily parameterize the groupings, summaries, and calculations as you can the filters. Collaboration. Typically, you'll find Excel files emailed back and forth all across an organization. People will make changes, add columns, add formulas, change things here and there, which makes it really difficult to reconsolidate and reconcile all the changes that have taken place. This is your worst case scenario. Now, in theory, it's a better idea in Excel to track your changes and share your work on a SharePoint site. But in practice, enabling track changes and putting your work on a SharePoint site disables a lot of the features of Excel. Also, if you've ever put a file up on a SharePoint site, you may have experienced people accidentally changing the file who shouldn't have, or people just going into the file and locking everybody else out of it. With R, you can publish your work to a server like RStudio Connect. People can view the files through their web browser, use all of the interactivity that you've included in the file, and you don't need to worry about people accidentally changing it who shouldn't. For your analyst team, you can share and track changes on a tool like GitHub. GitHub tracks all of the changes that take place between files. Now, the difference between this and something like track changes in Excel is that because an R file is a script which has the business logic in it, when there's a change, you see what the change in the business logic is. This has been a lecture from my course, R Reporting and Analytics for Excel Users.